Hui, a concert pianist and musicologist from Singapore, now based in London. I'm delighted to be part of Kris Foundation's Digital Concert, a new initiative that presents 30-minute curated programs. Today, I will be sharing the music of Clara Wieck-Schumann. She occupies a fascinating position not just in the history of the piano, but also in the history of women achievers. Her career as a concert pianist spanned 6 decades, starting as a child prodigy and concluding as a respected pedagogue. Her artistic partnership with her husband, Robert Schumann, was a rich exchange of ideas that shaped the course of German Romanticism. It's only in recent years that Clara's compositions have been getting more serious attention. It leads us to this question now today. How can we tell the story of Clara Schumann through her music with all the complexities of her identity? As a woman, a daughter, a wife, a mother, and above all, as an artist.
Thank you.
grasp of the public taste of the 1840s in Germany, where the audience preferred music that was virtuosic and easy to understand. It holds one of the more fascinating self-quotations in her compositions, the melody from her song, "He Came in Storm and Rain." The original poem speaks of an enigmatic figure, he, and the uncertainties and anxieties of new love. This brings us to the first movement of her sonata, which contains the same quotation of "He Came in Storm and Rain." Whether Clara meant for any personal significance or meaning is not something we can be absolutely sure of. In any case, the sonata was Clara's largest work for the solo piano and shows the network of stylistic influence between Weber, Mendelssohn, Chopin, and the Schumanns, and of course, the towering legacy of Beethoven. The sonata stayed undiscovered for 150 years until its publication in 1991. And here it is, reborn in the 21st century.
Thank you.
Clara Schumann's set of variations on a theme by Robert Schumann was written at the most difficult time, when Robert had been committed to an asylum. They contain some of the most innovative textures in piano writing, very colourful and unexpected harmonies, and a trademark of a mature style, which is that of the intricately woven, multi-layered voices. In the last variation, there is a self-quotation of a theme written when she was 12 in the Romance Verrier. Schumann apparently liked it so much that he quoted and used it for his own impromptus, Opus 5. And here's the romance from Clara. Good memories and simpler moments. I consider these variations as a testimony to her strength in the face of struggles.